Now let's introduce the second part, which is the first Monte Carlo learning algorithm in this lecture. The key to understanding the algorithm is to understand how to convert the policy iteration algorithm to be model-free. We know that policy iteration relies on a model, as we discussed in the last lecture. However, we can replace the model-based component of policy iteration with a model-free one. This will generate a model-free reinforcement learning algorithm. This is the core idea I hope everyone can pay attention to. So you should be familiar with policy iteration before proceeding. If not, please revisit the previous lecture. Now, let's explore how the policy iteration algorithm can be transformed into a model-free one. Policy iteration has two steps in each iteration: policy evaluation and policy improvement. What does policy evaluation do? For a given policy pi k, we calculate the state value v pi k by solving the Bellman equation. Once v pi k is known, we can improve the policy. How? Through solving this optimization problem to find a new policy pi k plus 1. We've talked about this before. Policy improvement can be written out for each state, resulting in this equation. This term is q pi k, the action value. How do we solve this optimization problem to obtain a new policy pi? Well, we select the maximum q pi k, as we've introduced before. So, the key quantity here is q pi k. Let's look at it more closely. When it comes to computing q pi k, there are two ways. The first way relies on the model. In this case, we first obtain v pi k, and then, since we know these models, we can compute q pi k. Apart from that, there is another way, which doesn't rely on the model. This way depends on the most primitive definition of action value, starting from state S, taking action A, and receiving a return, which is a random variable. We then compute its average or expectation. This is the action value's definition. So what's the core idea behind model-free reinforcement learning and Monte Carlo-based methods? It's to utilize this equation. We discard the model-based equation and use this one that's model-free. What is this? It's a mean estimation problem. As we discussed in the motivating example, Monte Carlo estimation can be employed to solve mean estimation problems. Now, let's talk about how it's specifically done. First, we start from any combination of state S and action A. Following the current policy, we generate an episode and calculate the corresponding discounted return. We denote this as GSA. This is the definition of action value. GT is the discounted return, which is a random variable, and GSA is a sample of this random variable. Suppose we have a set of episodes, we can compute the average of the returns to estimate the expectation of GT. This is Monte Carlo estimation, as we discussed in the motivating example. In summary, when we don't have a model, we need data. If we don't have data, we need a model. If we have neither, we can do nothing. The idea is very simple. So without a model, we use data. In statistics or probability theory, these data are called samples, while in reinforcement learning, they have a special name: experience. Up to this point, the algorithm has gradually become clear. This algorithm is called MC Basic, with MC being an abbreviation for Monte Carlo. Let's review the algorithm briefly. First, we start with an initial policy, which may not be optimal. We need to gradually improve it. In the kth iteration, it involves two steps: policy evaluation and policy improvement. In policy evaluation, we compute q pi k sa for all sa. The method involves starting from sa, obtaining many episodes, and calculating the average return of these episodes to estimate q pi k sa. Then, in the policy improvement step, based on q pi k obtained in the previous step, we solve an optimization problem to get a new policy. This is essentially the same as the policy iteration algorithm, with the only difference being in the first step. Policy iteration first solves for state value and then calculates action value, while MC Basic directly estimates q pi k from samples. Here's a pseudocode which is very similar to the policy iteration algorithm. First, in each iteration, I need to go through every state S. Then I need to go through all the actions corresponding to each state S. What do we do next? Starting from SA, We collect sufficiently many episodes and compute their average return, which is an estimate of Q pi Ks A. Then, in the next step, we improve the policy simply by selecting the action with the maximum action value. By now, we've completed the introduction of MC Basic. Next, we see some examples. But before that, I want to emphasize a few points. First, you should be able to see that MC Basic is a variant of the policy iteration algorithm. It can be obtained by removing the model-based component and replacing it with a model-free one. Therefore, it's crucial to note that the model-free algorithms are built up based on model-based ones. It is therefore necessary to study model-based algorithms first before studying model-free ones. Otherwise, you may encounter many questions, such as why we choose the action with the maximum value as a new policy, and so on. Additionally, MC Basic is useful to reveal the core idea of MC-based model-free reinforcement learning, but it is not practical due to low efficiency. We'll introduce two algorithms later on to improve its efficiency. Actually, you won't see MC Basic in other teaching materials. Since it's an algorithm I specifically designed in this course to clarify the core idea of MC-based reinforcement learning. In my opinion, when we study an algorithm, it is important to decouple its core idea from the complexities that may distract you. For example, replacing the model-based component in policy iteration with a model-free one is the very simple idea behind MC-based learning. Improving the efficiency will lead to a lot of complexities and will be discussed later. We'll explore methods to remove unrealistic assumptions, which can make the algorithm more complex but more practical. Anyway, understanding the core idea behind the algorithm first is crucial. Furthermore, in MC Basic, you may have noticed that it directly estimates action values. By contrast, in policy iteration, we first estimate state values and then calculate action values. Why do we directly estimate action values here? That is because state values cannot be used to improve policies directly. When models are not available, we should directly estimate action values. Additionally, we know that the policy iteration algorithm is convergent. Since MC Basic is essentially the same as policy iteration, its convergence is also guaranteed as long as we have sufficient samples. However, as our algorithms become more complex in the future, this theoretical guarantee of convergence may gradually disappear, or its analysis becomes more complex.